Hello, hello. This is Johannes Watery from HoldToRun. Today, I want to go through this awesome chart library that I found. It's an open source project. And we can now receive datasets in our application. So as you can see in here, I'm going to recap from where you can also get this chart library. It's a Kotlin and Compose. And quickly, we'll read through how I was able to implement this in my application. So maybe if you need chart libraries, you can also use this for your own setup. So the features, as you can see in here, is quite simple. We are receiving from the backend via REST API get method a list of data numbers. So, and now we can visualize that instead of just receiving a body of JSON or text or whatever, like those other ones in here. So I think this is very useful if you want to monitor a list of data instead of a generic text. So besides that, there are awesome built-in features in this library. We can zoom the offset and it is just perfect. So especially, let's say you would receive 1,000 value dataset, so you can quite easily change the perspective as you wish. And there's also long click. If this simulator can be responsive, maybe it'll work okay there. So I've customized this a bit, so you can pretty much start coding, building these show functions, onDraw functions, override functions, as I have done in here. So, and besides what I have shown you here, it actually can handle multiple line data sets in the one view. I'm just receiving one data set of a list to be drawn in here each time we refresh my backend response with the new data set. But I've been testing this in another project, in my daily work related project. And in there, I can actually change colors of the lines. I can visualize on top of each other multiple data sets, and it'll handle it perfectly. All you gotta do is just play a little bit how you set up this line graph and how you handle the onDraw functions and code your own solution beyond and above that. But perfectly usable line chart open source library. So we'll read this through today, how I implemented this into the API testing server doc application. And but before we start, if you like what I do, go check it out in HoldToRun.com. In here, you can see what I'm actively developing on my free time. And the demo that I'll be using today is done with the ServerDoc application, ServerDoc REST API testing application. If you like this, you can go directly into Google Play and test it out yourself. Okay, let's start. Okay, so let's start by looking the dependencies. So this chart library comes from developer Madrapps, and there's the git dependency implementation. So you need to add this into your build cradle to get your hands on to the program package. And then here, if you want to go, I'll leave this link into the YouTube video description, and in here you'll get some examples how this guy called TH Saravana has his setup for this chart plot library. So in here he's giving you some examples how you can already see that there's two data sets being drawn onto the view on the canvas, and what it can do. And there's no more than just line charts, but maybe you don't need pies or pillars or anything like that. Maybe this is just okay. And here you need to have the Maven Central, and like in my setup, the latest version was 0.1.2. Okay, and here he is giving the most basic setup to establish this line graph composable. So pretty much you pass in a list of lines, and inside of a line plot dot line, and that should do the job. I had to play a little bit with this one because this is bad implementation regarding you can't be sure if you have something in your list index 0 or 1, or you'll end up in an exception, out of bounds exception or something like that. So okay, let's take a look how I implemented this in the code. So in our chart view layout, this is a composable, we have exactly the same object as the developer had, line graph in here, and we are passing in line plot into the plot exactly how he had it, but we are creating our own line plot lines mutable state list in here up somewhere above. So here is one guard that the list is not empty. Okay, I ended up in exceptions which this library cannot handle by itself, and it seems it's not throwing anything at me that I could functionally catch in the composables at least easily. So I ended up making if check, if it's not empty then we draw that valid dataset list of float values, else we'll just tell the user that hey, it seems that you're not feeding us a object, it's not list of numbers, and we show that actual dataset that he tries to offer. So like this in here, let's see that let's take that list as a text. So pretty much if it's not valid object, the user will anyways see what he's trying to handle with this application. But let's go back into the chart view, and now we are receiving that chart in here. So this is REST API. So how do we get our hands on the dataset? So it comes into us as a response body, pretty much through the API response, whatever library you're using. I'm using, what the heck am I using? Sorry, can't remember what I'm using. Anyways, we are getting the result of the response body as a string. So that comes stored in my item, service item message. I have already handled it, and it's a string, so it can be pretty much anything, a message, a value or object or JSON string, or anyways, it's a JSON string. So I pass it in into composable launched effect, which is pretty much a thread that gets launched whenever these key values are changed. So we have key one and we have key two. So if we want to change colors of this background, like so in here, we are now in light mode. We can manipulate the colors of the lines by setting us custom colors in here via dark theme. Okay, that's one way. Then the other key value is actually the dataset string that comes from our REST API response. Okay, so whenever we have a new data, we launch this to update our chart. Okay, so those two are our triggers. So then the line graph requires line plot lines as a list. Okay, we need to create such object. So I have mutable state list of line plot line. Okay, now how do we fill this list? So first, whenever we launch, we have to obviously clear that because we don't want to keep on building on top of all data. Clear, okay. Then we will need data points, data point list that where we can save the exposition and the actual value, which creates our XY coordinates. Okay, the data point comes directly from the Madrapps library. So as long as you have set up his dependency, you'll get your access into this data class. It just holds X and Y float values. Okay. Then we are just creating our incrementing exposition into zero. Okay. And now we have to get our actual data values. So as this is JSON string directly from response body, so we have to deserialize that one. So I'm using my serialized class, customer class, but in here, this is JSON class that you can use, JSON object mapper. It is available for Kotlin and Java. And I'll just read the actual value and use class object of list. And with the star value inside of that list data type, we can pretty much deserialize anything that this holds. We don't know if it's number or string or anything, but of course it should be numeric value. Okay, so that's how we get to turn that JSON string into a list object of some value. Almost there. Now we have a list. So we don't know yet if it's a numeric value, though it should be. So we prepare our number list because we need float values. So we're going to start filling the objects from this list into this list if they are actually floats. Okay. So here we go through for each with that list that we just deserialized, and pretty much it's any data. We don't know, it is any data. As you can see, the data type is now any. We code through to string and our specific value will be float, and we use float or null, because if this cannot be converted into float, then well, heck, it's not numeric value. We'll just make it be null. Then we can check if you're not null, then it was an actual numeric value. And we can add it into our float list, like so. And now we can create our data point. So data points dot add, we create the data point object with our incremented exposition, which starts from zero, and at the end of each for loop we add plus one, so we get the depth we can create the depth of the x-axis, and we pass in the data value that we succeeded through this transformation in here. The number list that I'm also adding these in here, I have a reason. Why do I want to add these into my number list? Let me see. Is this something because I was about to do something cool? Maybe, maybe not. So, it seems I found a code which is invalid. I made some tests. I made some tests with this one, and it just was left there. No use for it. Okay, we can delete those ones when I'm done and release the app update. But okay, now into the data points, we can keep on adding in our value list the data point objects with the incrementing x, always plus one at the end of it, and pass to the y the actual data value that we transfer into float value if it's successful. Okay, now we should have our data points. Here's another guard. If you don't want this library to crash, don't build your line plot lines with empty data points. So if data points were not successfully created in this stage, don't pass in empty list of data points into your line plot lines mutable state list, because if you end up then passing this in here into the chart library, it's not gonna get caught in here. It's gonna successfully pass in empty line plot lines, and this library will crash. So I noted that one. That's why I'm using if check in here for the after I have tried to create the data points list in here. Okay, so then you can decide many things such as the colors, stroke width, radius, and highlight colors. So that's gonna affect anything you see in here. Now I have just a setup of white or darker white lines, and how the highlight bigger circle should be drawn, what color should be used on the dashed line behind, and etc. And there are many, many other things you can customize with this one in here. So, like so, now we want to pass in our mutable state line plot lines to actually draw this object. Okay, so if that launched effect successfully creates us this dataset, then we want to draw that line graph. So in here you can define the width and height. It definitely should have some maximum height so it doesn't try to fill your phone view. And so I have defined maximum height of 200. It just seems quite okay. And then we just pass the plots as line plot, and we have a list of line plot lines. Okay. So there, some other things are also being defined. The grid colors, line colors, are also how I define the dark and white theme. So I have only two set of colors in here. And steps defines you if you have 1, 2, 3, 4. I guess is it gonna be 1, 2? Anyways, that should define that I have 4 steps. And if you change that, you can see that you give 1, 2, 3, 4. That is 4 steps. You can get better resolution in in vertical aspect. You can enable the selection. You can highlight. Define your highlight colors, stroke width, the dashed path effect, like so the green dash path effect in there. Allow zoom. Well, I'm not even up to date yet what you can do with this, but I'm catching up. So I believe you start understanding the power of this simple open source Minecraft library. And that's pretty much what I wanted to show you today. So if you end up trying this, the first thing you probably think, how can I get that number drawn over there? So that is something I'll leave up to you, but also quickly where I handle that. So I pretty much set up myself a box which will be drawn on top of this card. So everything is inside the same card. And I'll just define width, height, and offset values. And I draw my color box by myself. And in here, I just keep track of point values as my custom objects. So I created my custom class, data class, data point line. We can have the X position, Y position, and the value as a float. So these we can then track in the line graph where you have these parameters, lambda parameters on selection start, on selection end, and on selection. In here you can this library, when you do the on long click and you start dragging, it'll actually pass you these values in these lambda functions. So you'll get the X line and you'll get the points. Either one, you have one or two or three data sets, then you can increment and get those values out from this library in here. So maybe you'll learn even more that I have learned so far and find new ways to fizzle around with this cool library for chart lines. Okay, I'll leave all the links, and truly thanks to this guy, Madrapps, because this is exactly what Kotlin and Android Jetpack Compose needs. So now we have something to build on in a native environment without taking a big third-party complex library. So, or heck, if you want, you can develop this by yourself, but don't if you learn to use this one. This is super. Okay, that's all. We'll be back.